chance here.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, for the introductions. This contest, scheduled for one fall, 45-minute time limit, and it is for the WSU World Championship. Introducing first, the challenger. Standing to my right, fighting out of San Bernardino, California, this is Jane. And her opponent, standing to my left, fighting out of Toronto, Canada, she is the current reigning and defending WSU World Champion. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Allie.
We have a dream match here on our hands as the main event of Resurgence, as Jade takes on Allie. And I would be so happy to see Jade finally shut up the shrieker that is Allie.
Not me. Allie's not going to intimidate Jade, but Jade, she's got a big task on her hands right there, trying to dethrone the 16-month title reign of Allie.
Allie has, I mean, despite my personal opinions of her,
which are positive,
she has gone undefeated for quite some time here in WSU.
Yeah, her undefeated streak's actually pushing 2 years. Yeah, that's not yours, Papa Giorgio.
Well, it might not be hers in a matter of moments, because Jade, this is the one championship she hasn't won, the one championship she wants to win and to make her career a Hall of Fame career. Here we go, and you can see Jade almost getting in the head of Allie right now as Jade nonchalantly staring down her opponent.
Wow. Both girls, they don't want to show each other that mutual respect there. Both of them pulling their hands away from that handshake.
I mean, did Allie really think Jade was going to fall for that?
Yeah.
I mean, I go back to when she broke her collarbone. She basically ripped all of us off.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you mean the part where she gallantly fought through a title match and defeated Candice LeRae?
No, I'm talking about where she...
afterward.
I'm talking about how she took all of our money. We worked for free that night. And then she ripped off her arm brace like nothing happened. And I'm not quite sure anything did happen.
She didn't only rip us off here.
They tried to rip each other's hair out there.
She ripped off all the fans. Okay?
All the females in the locker room, all to not take a payday to help her with her supposed surgery.
Completely despicable actions from Allie. And, you know, I try to be impartial, but after you do something like that, I gotta root for Jade. I'm sorry, I have
always
to.
Always about you.
He's not. It's not about him. He's just.
It's about the world title.
It is about the world title right now. We're just saying we would like to see Allie lose the world title here tonight at Resurgence.
I would like to see a world champion here in WSU that we can respect. That's what it boils down to. I want to be able to respect the champion at WSU. And while Allie has that championship, I'll go out and I'll say it. I don't respect the way that she is manipulating us, the fans, and holding on to that title.
And right now you can see how frustrated she is with Jade in the ring.
You guys say more negative stuff about the person on top than Megan Kelly does. Jerry Bomb Allie is the greatest superstar to ever come here in WSU. I mean, we saw Mercedes Martinez come back tonight. She built this company, but Allie has been the one that people have been most associative with of WSU the last several years.
Jade checks that kick.
She has a long way to go before she gets to a title reign like Mercedes Martinez.
Hey, Allie, as good as she is, she can't match kicks with Mia Yim.
Yes, this is not the proper game plan for Allie. You do not want to go strike for strike with Jade. It is a losing formula every time.
I grew up here, asshole!
Ooh.
Allie Allie's feeling herself right now, face palming Jade to the corner.
Things are getting intense already in this matchup, but we haven't seen a big offensive move from either of them, but we're about to see it right now.
Allie's actually effective with those leg kicks. I'm kind of surprised, honestly.
No, she's a good striker. She has good kicks. She's good.
And there we go. There she goes. Back to her old antics, asking for a timeout. Again, I didn't know there was timeouts in wrestling.
You get three of them per quarter.
That's
not
those
quarters now?
Nope, that's the NHL. Three per quarter.
Again, it's not the NHL.
Whatever. Oh, there. Allie able to cut her off right there. She lured Jade into this trap.
You know, I had to give the devil her due. Allie, as we've seen here in WSU, she can get it done.
Man.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, but Jade can also get it done taking out Allie. I think that's what's so frustrating about Allie.
Yeah.
She is a fantastic competitor, but she falls into these antics of hers.
She is. You're right. She's fantastic. Dragon screw leg whip. Halting that flurry of kicks from Jade. I'm going to strip the names of the whole match, so just bear with me, everybody. This is a new rule. Let's pee into the place.
Coming down hard on that leg, and this is the right strategy now that Allie is employing. You're going to want to take out that vertical base of Jade. If she's not able to stand, she's not able to hit you with those kicks of hers. And Allie, if she wants to come away victorious and walk away with the WSU World Championship, this is the strategy she needs to employ for the remainder of the match.
I concur. A lot of choking will work to her advantage. Keeping me Jade down will work to her advantage.
Hard into the buckle there. You're the smack of her face off of that turnbuckle. Very hard there.
Oh, man. And that's one of Allie's big moves right there that Jade was able to evade. Now coming back with her own cannonball in the corner.
And the War Queen now taking out her WSU champion. And this could spell the end. We could have a new champion in a few seconds here. Got a cover, but
she never got the right leverage. She wasn't going to put away Allie that way.
And Allie once again going to that left leg.
That's part of the reason she wasn't able to get the leverage on that pinfall attempt.
Absolutely.
The damage done to the leg.
Here comes Allie. Hard forearm to a seated Jade. And that near leg hook with the back press. Going for it again, trying to stay on top of Jade.
And this is something you saw momentarily there. It didn't do it so far, but every time someone kicks out of one of Allie's big offensive maneuvers, she begins to talk to herself. I don't know if it's a motivational tool to psych herself up, something Tony Robbins would have taught her or something along that nature.
I'm pretty sure it's just her whining and complaining is what it is. That is what she's known to do.
No, I see it differently. You're one to talk about people whining and complaining.
Come on, Jade. What do you
Jen,
say?
Please.
Huh? Jade just flipping her off.
And Allie kicked her right in the hand as well.
Yeah, as the finger was extended, too. That could have dislocated something.
You can see Jade is not able to get up back to her feet.
And Allie really can't allow her to. Keep her grounded.
Once again, face first into the buckle, and Allie
using a handful of hair, mind you.
Allie coming in fast, but not fast enough. Jade able to get up and over. Go for a tarantula here. She's got it.
Just completely stretching her out.
Well, you can see the pain in her eyes. The damage has been done to that leg.
Well, she knows the damage has been done. That's why she's going to try to end this thing by taking a big risk here in this championship fight. Oh, but it doesn't work out for her.
Oh, she tumbled all the way to the floor, too.
Allie, one step ahead.
Bounced on the apron on the way down to the floor.
Hey, you don't hold a big-time title for 16 months letting people gain any momentum in the course of a match. You got to be one step ahead at all times.
Jade coming up, still hobbling. She probably came down at an awkward angle on that leg, too.
Jade using every bit of this count to gain her composure.
Breaking the count, if barely.
Phil Geek guys would complain if Allie did that.
You see, Allie likes to constantly run away. This is for Jade to get herself some much-needed rest, and at the same time frustrating the WSU champion. She knows that Allie, that's one of her biggest.
Oh, look at that.
Yep.
That is her primary kicking leg, and when she made contact with that kick, it sent a wave of pain up and down her leg. And man, Allie is doing the right thing here.
Yes, Allie, not going for a traditional Boston Crab, going for the single leg to truly isolate the damage that's been done.
The single leg crab does damage to the leg. A full Boston Crab, there's a lot more pressure on the lower back. She's not concerned about the lower back right now. She's concerned about that leg.
She wants to make sure that Jade just cannot stand to defend herself.
What do you say?
I'm pretty sure she's successful in that.
1, 2, 3, 4 off the throat.
It's nice to hear you say something good about her.
Hey, I have said it before. Allie is a fantastic competitor. It's just, I just can't stand her personality. There, I said it. But right now,
straight shooting out here.
Yeah. Hope she hears this. Allie getting ahead of steam, but gets caught by the strength of Mia Yim.
And Mia Yim.
It's contagious.
Jade. Here she comes. Not going to fall into the trap, guys.
There's Cherry getting the advantage again, but gets thrown off by Jade. For a clothesline, Jade from behind. Oh, using what's left of her energy to bring her over with that German.
You can see though her leg gave out on her with that.
Yeah, she wasn't able to get the full impact on that German suplex.
Yeah,
she didn't even have a chance to try to hold it for a pin attempt there.
Yeah, with the damage to her leg, she couldn't bring the energy to it, power to her hips to pop them.
Top of Georgia up to a count of six. Both ladies up nearly at the same time, ducking out of the way. That clothesline is Jade. Now Jade's starting to fire up. What a flurry of offense out of Jade. Kicking Allie back down to the mat. Jade's got something in mind here.
Oh, running, shooting star, and twisting in midair too.
A running, twisting shooting star press out of Jade with her leg in that condition. That shows you just how much she wants that WSU World Championship.
She is absolutely fighting through the pain to make sure she walks out with this title.
Everything goes right back to that leg. Allie kicks it, and she goes right down like a sack of potatoes into a cover, only getting a two count.
But that was really close there, Dan. Nick Papagiorgio's hand was coming down really close for that three count. And you can see Jade, she's out of it right now after that combination of kicks.
You don't hold the title for 16 months without figuring out ways to capitalize on your opponent's mistakes. Or you don't.
Backdrop suplex.
Once again, she can't really get over for the proper cover and only getting a two count.
Yeah, I don't know if the camera picked up on it, but on the bridge, Jade was maneuvering her leg around to try to take as much pressure off it as possible. And her doing that led to an ineffective pin attempt. Jade saying that belt is hers, looking for a package pile driver.
There's that leg again.
She doesn't have the strength left. She does not have the strength left. Best super kick ever. Misses. Back fist to the future. Misses. Oh, there it is.
There it is, the BSC.
That's what brought her the championship.
1, 2, and 3.
Yes.
Here is your winner. WSU World Champion, Allie!
And the reign continues of Allie here in WSU.
You know, I said what I said about Allie at the beginning of this match, but I gotta give the devil her due. She fought hard for this win. She employed the proper strategy, and she was able to put Jade away. I just wish Allie could act this way.
No, Larry, what are you doing, Larry?
No, I would not have done that. I would not have.
She would have intimidated you into doing that. 16 months, guys. The longest reigning champion
Those are some big words.
This is my belt! I have blood, sweat, and tears for this belt! And no one back there, nobody on this roster can touch me.
Those are some big words.
Well, they're correct words. She's bragging and doing it in good style. She's trumping.
I'm not sure she realizes who made her return here tonight. The longest reigning WSU champion in history. 1,095 days, and she is going right back to where she came from, right back to the top of the mountain. And notice how calm and cool and collected she is. She doesn't have to say anything.
Oh, look at the respect by the champion.
I suggest you step back a couple of feet as I'm walking into this ring, Mamita. That's what I thought. You may call yourself the dominant female in WSU, but that's only because I was gone. Remember that. That belt was around my waist for almost 3 years. Three! You've had it for what? One?
One and a
what
third.
What an accomplishment that is. But you haven't faced someone like me. So this is what I'm going to say to you, Miss Allie. That belt, November 19th, me and you.
Yeah. I want to see that.
There's nobody in WSU that is as dominant as Mercedes Martinez. So keep talking the talk. But on November 19th, I will walk the walk and have that belt back home where it belongs.
Yeah, let's get that booked. Let's set that up right now.
Don't accept the challenge, Allie.
I'm pretty sure she has to accept.
She's not legally obligated.
She already put it out there. Stay logged on to czwrestling.com/WSU for complete details on our return to streamczw.com on November the 19th. But that's not going to do it for us here tonight. We have so much more action here on streamczw.com as tonight, Down with the Sickness, it's Combat Zone Wrestling's biggest...